Hello, I'm Calm Cal. Welcome to another video. In this video, we're going to go back to an old series that we started a few months ago, which is Improve or Reuse Your Tired Laptop. In this video, I want to show you how to install Batocera on the internal hard disk drive. It's taken a while to go back to this series because I've been waiting for someone to donate an old laptop, which I've now got. This laptop that was donated doesn't suit Batocera. The system specifications for this laptop are just not compatible, and it's just not feasible to use Batocera on this laptop. In the next video, I do repurpose this old laptop. The main point of this video is just to show you how to install Batocera on the internal hard disk drive, which we are going to do. So, if you have followed the previous video for this, retro gaming just on a USB stick, you will already have Batocera installed on your USB stick. So what we need to do is get this computer to boot from the USB stick. So here I am just in the BIOS, just trying to sort out which of these is the actual USB port that we need. So I'm just changing every one that says USB at the front to boot first before anything else. So if you're unsure how to actually get Batocera on your USB stick, have a look at my previous video and we'll go through all of this with you, including this BIOS screen as well. This one is slightly different from the previous version, but you've got all the options at the very top, with the system configuration is the one that we need for this particular one. Using the previous laptop, I had to boot in legacy mode. This is not an option on this laptop. So I'm just going to press F10 on here to accept. Then I'm just going to go over to File, Save Changes and Exit, and then press F10 again for yes. I already have the Batocera USB stick plugged in, so now when it reboots, it will boot from the USB stick. As you can see, this computer is already struggling in the menu system. It is very, very sluggish, which is down to the system configuration of this old laptop. All we'll do now is press the space bar for the main menu and then go down to system settings, press enter, go all the way down to the bottom to install Batocera on a new disk. You will need an internet connection for this. If you've got an old computer that hasn't got an Ethernet port, you can use one of these USB Ethernet portable adapters. I did use this adapter just to check to see whether it would work out of the box, and it did. And here is the USB to Ethernet adapter, which for these type of old systems and the new systems that just work on Wi-Fi, it's great to have in your toolbox. So I just plugged this in, worked automatically. So just trying again, press spacebar and you just select the target device. And that's the internal drive, which is 150 gig, and then the target architecture is x86, and it is a 64-bit computer. And then just for validation, just to make sure everything's right and you're sure, just highlight yes I'm sure and then press enter and then install. And now Batocera will download via the internet and it will install the latest version of Batocera. It won't install the version that is on the USB stick or the ROMs. This process will take a little bit of time dependent on your internet speed. But once done, select shutdown from the menu on Batocera, then take out the USB stick, turn back on the computer, go back into your BIOS, pressing the relevant key. On this one it's F10 for me to get into the BIOS, and then select boot from the internal hard disk drive. Let it boot up, and then you can plug in your USB stick once it's booted up, and then press F1, and then copy your files across from your USB stick to your internal hard drive. And we'll just show you the performance of this system once installed. You can see that it dips down to 7 frames per second up to about 9 frames per second. This laptop just isn't compatible with this type of software. It's something to do with the system configuration. I did try this system as well with a modern SSD and it was just the same. Things don't always go to plan, but we make the best of what we can. In the next video, I do show you how we get this system up and running with an up-to-date operating system and back on the internet. And I will release this new video at the same time as this video. My name is Cal. Have a good morning, afternoon, or good evening. Farewell till next time, and I will see you later. Show that bit of gameplay, make sure it's working okay. Start it and done. Okay, pick that up. You see, it's working fine, no lag, no nothing. I'm really impressed with this emulation, to be honest. I'll just come out of here, so I'm going to press and hold these two buttons down.